Hi, I'm Tony Kramer with RDO Equipment Company. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of the Agriculture Technology Podcast.
Every day, there are phenomenal advancements being made in the field of agriculture technology. RDO Equipment Company is a leader in agriculture equipment and precision agriculture technology and is here with industry experts bringing the latest news and information from RDO and John Deere. Every day, there are phenomenal advancements being made in the field of agriculture technology. RDO Equipment Company is a leader in agriculture equipment and precision agriculture technology and is here with industry experts bringing the latest news and information from RDO and John Deere.
Welcome back to another episode of the podcast. This is episode number 132, and today we are going to be talking about planter performance upgrade kits. Before we dive into the show, please take a moment to subscribe to this podcast if you haven't already. You can subscribe to the show on the many different podcasting apps that we are streaming this out to, such as Apple's podcast app. We've got it on Stitcher, Overcast, SoundCloud, as well as many others. While you're out there, drop us a review. We'd love to hear what you think about the show. Lastly, make sure to follow RDO Equipment Company on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and catch all of our latest videos on YouTube. You can also follow me on Twitter at RDO Tony K. Now with that, let's get back to the show. I'm very excited to welcome back Bryce Nolan. Bryce is a product specialist here with RDO Equipment Company. Like I said, very excited to get him back on the show. Bryce has actually been on twice. First episode was back in episode 27 when we were showcasing the 9RX with the 2730 Ripper behind it. We were out in the field having fun. So if you haven't listened to that one, go back and listen to episode number 27. And Bryce was also on episode number 63 when we were celebrating, RDO was celebrating its 50th anniversary. And we had talked to a long-term employee, and Bryce was gracious enough to share a story about that employee. So he was on then as well. But welcome back to the show, Bryce. To get started, you know, let's just remind people kind of who you are, where you come from, and how you got to where you are today.
Yeah, thanks, Tony. Good to be back. So like Tony said, I'm Bryce Nolan. I am a product specialist with RDO Equipment Company. I've been with the company for about 8.5 years now. I started up at the parts counter, Moorhead, Minnesota location. Did that for about 3.5 years and then transitioned into a product specialist role and have been doing that ever since. So a lot of background, a lot of things growing up, farm related. So been around agriculture all my life and continue on with it. So really happy to be doing what I'm doing and dealing with technology every day.
Awesome. Thanks again for doing this, Bryce, and sharing a little more information about some of the stuff you deal with on a daily basis. So getting into it, performance upgrade kits. So we talk a lot within the John Deere portfolio of equipment. We can offer numerous different performance upgrade kits. Now, today in this episode, we are going to solely focus just on planter performance upgrade kits. So starting out, Bryce, I just want you to explain to our listeners, what is a performance upgrade kit?
Yeah, so they changed the name. John Deere changed the name here a couple years ago. They used to refer to them as retrofit kits. Going forward now, they are now performance upgrade kits. So what we can do with these kits on planters specifically is we can update an older planter. So coming down to all the way back to 2005, and I'll get into compatibility a little bit later, but we have the ability to add new row units or components, other technology components onto an existing frame. And make that planter brand new again from a meter standpoint. So taking an old frame, old bar, turning that into a brand new planter, new technology, electric drive, that type of stuff. That's what we're able to do with the performance upgrade kits today.
So this is something if a customer were interested in maybe increasing the level of technology or doing a little more with their planter, this is a potential solution they could go or use versus buying a brand new planter off the factory floor or maybe even finding a new to them used machine. This is another route that they could also go as well, correct?
Yep, exactly. So just going back to the meters and brand new meters, and you mentioned looking at brand new planters, we all know what those cost. So the ability to make a brand new planter out of an older frame is a big deal. And obviously our row units is what's putting that seed in the ground. So making that those components brand new, wear parts, etc., that really adds a lot of value to the life of your machine.
So if a customer were interested in a performance upgrade kit, I know you've talked about the row units, the meters, things like that. What exactly are the options, or what can a grower get in a performance upgrade kit?
Yeah, so for model year 21, John Deere's released some new components and some technologies for the performance upgrade kits. A lot of this stuff was not able to be purchased unless you had a brand new planter. So another big value selling point there. But so we have the option to put two different meters on, one of them being our ExactEmerge, which is going to be our brush belt system, our high productivity, high accuracy planter. We could also go with a MaxMerge 5E, which is a MaxMerge 5 unit, but it's electronically driven, just like our ExactEmerge. So both electric planter systems is what we can put on for meters. Some of the other stuff we can put, individual row hydraulic downforce. So looking out into the market and seeing hydraulic downforce becoming a very, very big game player, we have the ability to add that to an older unit now as well, or older system. For the guys that maybe have an older planter with spring system downforce, we can also go to active pneumatic downforce if they don't want to make the big jump all the way up to hydraulic. So that's another option there. And then some pneumatic easy adjust row cleaners. So right from the cab, we can adjust row cleaners, our depth, our pressures, how much material and product that's moving out of the way before the true V openers can place that seed into the seed bed. So we can add those as well as pneumatic closing wheels. So the ability to adjust our pressure of closing wheel in different soil conditions right from the cab as well. We're used to the spring tension where we got the 4 or 5 settings on the back and having to get out of the cab and adjusting those. Now we can do that all right from our screen in the cab. So some big units there. And then also starting talking about some JD Link stuff. So Connect Mobile is a big game player. That's our ability to connect an iPad right to that planter and see row by row monitoring right in the cab as well. Along with that, we get the mobile row unit runoff. So walking around the planter with the iPad in hand, we can test and run every single row unit on that planter. So starting at number 1 all the way through 24, 36, however many row units you have, we can go through and do a test stand on every single one of those and make sure that they are performing optimally before we even take the machine to the field. So that's an industry exclusive there. That's a big game changer as well. And then SeedStar 3HP or SeedStar 4HP software. So really what that comes down to is what display does the customer currently have today? Do they have a 2630? Do they have Gen 4 technology, either a 4640 or 4600 in the tractor? And how do they want to operate that planter? So John Deere gives two options of software to be able to put on these performance upgrade kits.
So what I'm hearing now, Bryce, is with everything that you explained, everything from the row meters to you talk downforce, row cleaners, those easy adjust row cleaners to be able to adjust from the cab, all of that kind of, it's part of the package. So you have the row unit that I would imagine is kind of your focus. We want to upgrade the technology of that row unit, or that meter, I should say, the meter itself. All of that kind of comes in. Now, can you get some of these components kind of a la carte? Can you pick and choose, or does it have to be a big package, or how does that work exactly?
Yeah, so, you know, it kind of depends on what direction each customer wants to go. So we have the ability to pick and choose what we want on these. We don't have to deck the planter out if we don't want to. We can go real narrow with our options, but the ability to add these different components on these older planters is becoming a really big deal. Like I said earlier, the cost of brand new machines is, as everyone knows, fairly high and cannot fit everybody's budget. So this is another option for that. So we can mix and match. We can kind of do whatever configuration we want.
Yeah, and that's kind of really what I was looking for, is the fact that it's very customer specific. It's very planter specific. So talk to your salesman, talk to the people that you're working with on this, and make sure you get what's right for your operation. we talked about adding all of these different components. One of the things that I always question, of course, Bryce, is the iron, the hardware that's already on that planter. Are we getting just the additional technology, a new meter, a new row cleaner, things like that? Or are we also replacing some of the iron and hardware? How does that all work with these performance upgrade kits?
Yeah, good question. So if we were talking 3 years ago, I would tell you you're just getting the meter for the most part. All the wear parts is going to be separate from this. But starting in model year 21 now, Deere released the fact of we are getting a new shank. We're pretty much getting everything from the bar back. So we unbolt that row unit off of the existing planter and bolt the new one on is really what it comes down to. So you start looking at wear parts and some things like that that get pretty spendy pretty fast when we got to do 24 or 36 of them across the whole planter. We are now getting all brand new wear parts. These are assembled, ready to be put on right from John Deere. They're torqued, they're spec'd, they are a unit that would be put onto a brand new planter if one was rolling down that assembly line. So the value there has become way higher, right? So all new wear parts, like I said, bushings, all the gauge wheel arms, things like that, those main components that wear out anyways, we're getting those all brand new. So becoming very, very popular. We've had a lot of conversations about them over the past couple years, and now to add this extra value in there. And you start looking at it from an install perspective too, right? So before we were getting bits and pieces and parts and things here and there unassembled, now the ability to take a whole row unit off of a crate and bolt that onto the frame, everything's torqued already, becomes way quicker install, a lot less labor to do it, and frankly, if a customer's handy enough, they can do it themselves.
Yeah, it sounds like it's gotten much easier, a lot more components added into these performance upgrade kits. Like you said, when they first released and they were kind of referred to as that retrofit kit, it was just the meter. There wasn't much or there wasn't anything for iron unless you were upgrading certain model year planters, upgrading to an Xactimerge, you'd get a new shank with that. But John Deere has definitely made it easier for the customer, more cost effective as well for the customer to get into these performance upgrade kits. Now, I talk about cost effectiveness and ease of purchase. As a customer, Bryce, how do I go about purchasing one of these performance upgrade kits?
So these performance upgrade kits are in the whole good system. So account manager, salesman, obviously want you to talk to your local RDO equipment dealer, product specialist, myself, whoever. But they are in the whole good system. So we can sit down and go through what options you may or may not want on your particular planner. We can get you a quote and look at it in that form.
When you were talking about what comes with these and how it's the parallel arms back and everything, this truly is a full kit. It's not just a component bundle that you may get over the parts counter, correct?
Yep, that is correct. Yep.
So that can't stress enough to make sure you talk to the right people. You talk to your sales professional. You talk to a product specialist, your local John Deere dealership, local RDO if you are in our territory. Make sure you are going through the proper steps to figure out what exactly you need for your operation. Now, is there any sort of a success story that you have, Bryce? I know you've been involved in a sale or two of these performance upgrade kits for planters specifically. What is there any sort of a story you'd like to share about customers that have gone this route versus purchasing a new planter?
Yeah, so like Tony said, about 2 or 3 years ago now, we did end up selling a 48-row kit out of one of my stores, and we were up against a competition, and I don't even need to say their name. I'm sure he can probably figure out what competition that was. But in the end, the customer did decide to go with a John Deere system, and the main reason was resale. One single word, resale. And that's the reason he decided on a John Deere kit. The biggest thing he was after in that kit was the IRHD. And after we got it up and running and out in the field, I was riding in the cab with them, and it was a wet spring, so the tillage that was done right before the planter was, moderate. You could see wheel tracks still in the field. They had a big wide track machine out there that made that tillage. And if you watch the IRHD page right from the display, when we crossed those passes where that tractor had been with a tillage, you could see those rows increase and decrease as we were. It was almost like a heartbeat running across the screen. It was pretty impressive. And that was one thing that the customer pointed out to me and said, look at this. This is unbelievable how fast this reacts to the compaction layers. And that was by far the biggest thing that they saw the value in. And they, of course, like the 5E row units that they put on as well. But the IRHD, that downforce system, was something that they could not live without. And they were extremely happy that they made that decision.
Yeah, and that's an awesome example of looking for a specific component of a performance upgrade kit. In this case, the customer is looking for individual row hydraulic downforce. I would imagine, like you said, they were looking at the competition. That's a big strain on our part is some of the competition offers very easy performance upgrade or retrofit kits, and now we offer that same kit. And this story just kind of goes to show that there's value in doing that. There's value in finding the solution that's right for your farm. So awesome to hear that story. Great to hear the reason behind the performance upgrade kit and then what the customer saw by adding that component and feature. So, Bryce, you talked about all of the different components, what we can and can't get in these kits. My next question is, are there certain limitations to these kits? What is the compatibility when it comes to John Deere planters and a performance upgrade kit?
Yeah, so there are some compatibility limitations, but for the most part, we covered most of the John Deere planters from 2005 and newer. Deere has added 5 different models this year, and primarily those being some of the smaller 12-row units, 3-point models, stuff like that. But technically speaking, 2005 and newer John Deere planters are compatible, and then also DB planters starting with model year 2012 on up. The nice thing with Deere is what they've added as well is some custom configurations. So what's that? They've added the ability for us to send a serial number in, send the information from what the customer wants. Does he want an exact emerge? Does he want a 5E? What other technologies does he want? And then they will look at those on a case-by-case basis and decide if that planter is fit to add a performance upgrade kit or not. So I've had some success with this in the past as well. But it is another big option if we have maybe a 2010 DB that's not compatible. We can send that off to custom, and Deere will take a look at it and see if it is compatible or not.
Yeah, there again, just the ease or the willingness to work with the customer, figure out what makes sense and what's right. So few limitations when it comes to compatibility. We don't go to some of that much older equipment, but here we are in 2020, and we're still going back to 2005, 2012, depending on what your frame is. So there is quite a bit of compatibility there, and it's definitely a solution, or can be a solution, for the right customer and the right farm. You know, Bryce, if someone wants to learn more, maybe talk about, maybe they're interested in a performance upgrade kit for their planter, whether it be for the upcoming 2021 season. I don't know what ordering looks like, so I don't know what you would get or how soon you would get it, but maybe someone's looking at something for 2022. But either way, if they want to learn more, where can they go? Who can they talk to?
Yeah, by all means, talk to myself, get a hold of me, go into your local RDO equipment dealer and or your local John Deere dealer, talk to a salesman. They should have the information they need to help you out, as well as, johndeere.com as well. They will have information on performance upgrade kits on there.
Great. Thank you very much, Bryce, again, for sitting down with me, coming back onto the show. I always welcome return guests. You guys make it easy on me because you've done it in the past. So thanks again for doing this and talking planter performance upgrade kits.
You bet. Thanks, Tony.
Thanks for tuning in to another episode. If you have questions about the technology and products discussed or have ideas about future episodes, please leave them in the comments below. You can also subscribe to RDO's YouTube channel and be in the know about each episode, or tune in on any streaming service. Thanks for listening.